Hello and welcome back everyone. So in this video we are going to talk about namespaces, and from the name it's clear that we need to create a namespaces to isolate the code. Either you can use a module pattern or you can bind a particular JavaScript code to the global object like this. So here I created an app as a global object, and then I'm creating the functions under it. All the functions under it, app.id, even the variable declaration, app.next, app.reset, or the same thing I can do something like this. Inside of my app, I will declare all my methods. So namespaces means we need to isolate the code to the outside world so that there is no collision of variables, no collision of functions, and it should be totally isolate. So from this module, you will just export my app, and in the another module you can just execute my app.next, my app.reset, my app.id. I mean, you don't want it to put anything globally, anything to global object directly. So you can wrap everything inside a my app. This is like a isolate namespace you have created. Or better, you can create the module pattern something like this. So it is surrounded by if block, and here you can play around with your private functions and private variables because they are not going to be accessed directly from the outside. You cannot do my app.id, right? You cannot get this value directly because id is a private, correct? So if you try to access it, so let me just do console.log. You are getting undefined, right? Even you cannot execute all these methods, myapp.next, you can execute. Because from this module pattern, we are revealing these two objects, next and reset. So when you are assigning myapp, myapp is representing a if block which is immediately being invoked, right? Now I can do myapp.next. Next is a private function being exposed from here. So this is known as a revealing pattern in JavaScript, that you have some private properties and private functions, but still you are able to access it directly from outside by calling the next function. Because next I'm revealing, next what next is doing, next is accessing this private property, right? And I'm getting that value, fine. So this is how we actually reveal the private functions and private variables. Whatever you declare with the var keyword is a private. You cannot directly access that thing directly outside the function. So like function hello, and if I try to access, like create a new object, obj dot a value, what do you think, what value you will be getting from here? It will give you undefined. You are not having the property which is public. I mean, if you are declaring the same value with this dot a equal to 90, then you might be accessing this value and you will get the value 90, right? Because this is a public property. Or what you can do, you declare the property as a private and you reveal, or you should return a function. So this would be another function